हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. आई एम वैशाली किकान एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द VLSI टेक्नोलॉजी. टुडे दिस इज द लास्ट वीडियो ऑन द पैकेजिंग एंड वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द कंसीडरेशंस एंड टाइप्स ऑफ द पैकेजिंग. राइट, सो बोथ ऑफ दीज आर रियली इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी शोन यू द पिक्चर्स ऑफ द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ पैकेजिंग. So now we are going in detail about the types of packaging. What are the advantage of a particular type of packaging? That is the thing that we are going to see in this video. If you have still not watched the previous video where I have talked about the introduction and the parameters for the packaging, then it is essential that you go back, watch these two videos on the packaging first and then come to this video. Plus, I hope you all are watching this video with your utmost attention. If not, please watch it carefully because here we are going to deal with a lot of terminologies, right? So let's start. So these are all of the type of packaging that we have, right? So first of all, we have dual inline packaging, which is called the DIP package. Yes, we have all seen it in the labs as well. After that, we have single inline package, which is SIP package. After that, we have thin small outline package, which is called TSOP package, right? So you can see it is a very thin type of packaging that we have. After that, we have quad flat pack, which is QFP, right? You can see this is the kind of structure that we have for the QFP. After that, we have the plastic leaded chip carrier, which is the PLCC. So this is how the PLCC is going to look like, and I hope you can relate it with the real-time ICs that you must have seen in your labs, right? After that, we have leadless chip carrier, which is called LCC. So now we are going to discuss about all of them in detail, plus we are going to see what are the advantage associated with a particular kind of IC. So now coming to the packaging considerations. So the packaging is a very important component in the VLSI technology. Why? Because the packaging is going to influence a lot of parameters and properties and attributes of the given IC, right? So if I change the packaging, the properties or attributes of a given IC is going to change. If I have SIP and if I have DIP, both of them are going to give different properties to the given IC. And this is how I can say the packaging is one of the most important component of the VLSI technology, right? So what all properties are going to depend upon the packaging? First of all, the size is going to depend upon the packaging. So you can see here we have the QFP and we have the TSOP, right? So in the QFP, we can see the size is bigger than you can see the, in the TSOP. So here we have the thinner structure and here we have the thicker structure. Whenever I want the application where I want the thin structure, I will be switching towards the TSOP, right? If I want some structure where I want this kind of structure and the application will be involving the involvement of this kind of structure, I will be moving towards the QFP. Right, so size greatly depends upon the type of packaging that we are using, and you can see this with the help of this figure. We have different types of packaging, all of them are having different size. Right, after that, the maximum pin count of the IC also depends upon the type of packaging. If I change the type of packaging, the maximum pin count is going to change. Right, that is also a very big phenomena that depends upon the type of packaging. If I have some complex application, it will be requiring more number of pins, more number of inputs are required for the processing, more number of outputs are generated after a complex processing. For that, I require more pins. So you can see the number of pins depend upon the packaging type. You can see here, if I have QFP and if I have DIP, in the DIP, I have the pins only at this surface, this terminal and the this terminal, right? In the QFP, on all of the four sides, we have the pin. So the pin depends upon the type of packaging. After that, the environmental protection or the reliability also depends upon the type of packaging, right? The speed depends upon the type of packaging. Speed is greatly depending upon the type of packaging because the RC time constant is generally giving the speed. right? If the RC time constant is changed, the speed would be changed, right? And this R and C component depends upon the type of packaging. Further, the inductance also depends upon the packaging. So I can say about 1/3 of the speed is based upon the packaging only, because 1/3 of the change in the resistance, capacitance and the inductance is caused by the change in the packaging only. So this is a very important criteria. Now coming to the cost driving force for the packaging technology. The cost driving force for the packaging technology is the microprocessors, right? We are highly using the packaging in the microprocessors these days, and here we are using the gate arrays, and this is due to the high pin count that are required in the logic chips, right? And I hope you understand, if I have high pin count, it generally greatly depends upon the type of packaging. So type of packaging is going to influence the pin count, and then it is going to influence the type of gate array, and then in turn the microprocessor functioning. So I hope you understand this thing. So if I subdivide the packaging, so the package types are broadly subdivided into two categories, that is thorough hole types and the surface mount types. So both of them are really different. So in the thorough hole types, we have the DIP, that is dual in line package, which is having 8 to 64 pins. After that, we have pin grid array, which is PGA, which is having 64 to 301 pins. Right, so if I compare, the PGA is having much higher number of pins than the DIP, right? So after that we have the surface mount types. In the surface mount types, we have the flat pack, which is having 16 to 360 pins, and then we have the chip carriers, which is having 52 to 244 pins, right? So I hope you understand the basic broad classification of the packaging types in the thorough hole and the surface mount types, right? So now if I again classify the packaging type based upon the material of the packaging, I can classify it as ceramic type or the plastic type. The plastic type is inexpensive as compared to the ceramic type of packaging, but here we have the metal lead frames, right? So the metal lead frames are used with the plastic type of material. Now in the ceramic, we have the hermetic seal against the environment, right? Here I can use the thick film conductors on the alumina. And ceramic type of packaging would be very highly tolerable towards the humidity present in the environment. So you can see the ceramic type of packaging has its own advantage. The plastic type of packaging has their own advantages. So now coming to the basic difference between the surface mount SM or the thorough hole TH type of technology. If I classify all of the structures based upon the surface mount and the thorough hole, in the thorough hole I will be having DIP, QFP and PGA. But in the surface mount, I will be having SOP, PLCC and LCCC. So now the surface mount and the thorough hole are having the different chip size packaging, right? And they will be having multi-chip modules, right? So this is how we will be having the difference in the surface mount and the thorough hole. The thorough hole uses a precision hole drilled through the board and plated with the copper, right? So here inside the thorough hole type of packaging, we will be having a precision hole also at the center. Mostly we will be having this precision hole, which is drilled through the board and it is plated upside with the copper. Now what is the advantage of thorough hole type? There will be having a sturdy support for the chip carrier, right? So there will be high support as compared to the surface mount type. So it resists the stress caused by the expansion of the components at the raised temperature. So the thorough hole type of packaging would be working fine at a higher temperature, as well as if I supply the higher stress, then the thorough hole type of packaging is going to work better. So now coming to the surface mounts. In the surface mount, a chip carrier is soldered to the pads on the surface of the board. Now coming to the advantages of the surface mount, here we will be having the smaller component size, and the size matters a lot, right? If I want a compact structure or compact output, I will be requiring the compact intermediate substances. So IC is an intermediate substance. I want it to be as compact as possible, and for that I will be using the surface mount type. Here we will be having the lack of thorough holes, and we will be having the possibility of mounting chips on both sides of the PC board. But in the case of Thorohold, I can mount the PC or the chip on the one side of the chipboard only, right? So this is how we can have the difference between the surface mount and the Thorohold. So now coming to the DIP type of packaging. Here we will be having the rectangular package with two rows of pin in its two sides. I hope you remember the structure. So you can see we have the pins only on the two sides, right? And this is a rectangular type of structure. So now we will be having the pins at the two rows of its two sides. In the QFP, we are providing the pins at the all of the four sides, but in the PGA, in the pin grid array, we have the entire bottom surface with the pins. So the entire bottom surface is covered with the pin rather than only at the periphery we are having the pins. So in the pin grid array, obviously we will be having the most number of pins, then the QFP, and then the DIP. In the DIP, we will be having the least number of pins for the given size of the IC. So now coming to the small outline packages. Small outline packages are also called SOPs. It is having the gull wing shaped leads, right? So you can remember this term. It is having a gull wing shaped leads, and what is the advantage? It requires less pin spacing, right? So the spacing between two pins will be less, which means it is again going to give me more number of pins and a completely smaller size of the packaging. Now coming to the plastic leaded chip carrier, which is the PLCC. Now the advantages of PLCC is that it offers high pin count than SOP also, as J leaded chip carriers are packed denser than the SOPs also. I told you in the SOP we have less distance between the two pins. In the PLCC we have even lesser distance, which means it is more denser and it will be having more number of pins as compared to SOP. Now coming to the leadless ceramic chip carrier, which is LCCC. The conductors are left exposed around the package over here, right? So we are not having any pins and the conductors are exposed from the IC only. Now what is the advantage? If I am not using the pins, I am directly exposing the conductor. So it is using the multi-layer ceramic technology, which is having high thermal conductivity, which means it is going to give me higher speed. So now the packaged IC consists of several parts which are connected together mechanically as well as electrically. So which all parts are connected mechanically or electrically with the help of the packaging? The chip or the die. Obviously I have to connect the chip, right? So this is called the actual device or the circuit. After that we have the lead frame or the thick film metal, which is connected inside of the package to the outside pins for the PCB mounting, right? So first of all I have the chip, then we have the lead frame, and after that we have the wire bonds which are connecting the die to the package electrically. We should supply the current from outside environment to the IC which is inside the packaging, and for that I will be using the wire bonds. And then I have the outer package, which is composed of the ceramic material or the plastic material. So now coming to the design rules. What are the design rules that we are following while making the packaging for a given IC? The bonding pad spacing on the chip is really critical. Where we are placing the bonding pad is really important, right? So a minimum spacing between the two pads is required, otherwise pads are going to get shorted out, right? So the spacing between the pads is required. Typically there is a maximum and the minimum wire length. The wire span over the silicon is also limited, right? So now coming to the thermal consideration. So in the thermal consideration, obviously we are going to talk about the temperature. So device or the junction temperature must be kept below some limit to prevent the temperature activated failure mechanisms. If the temperature will be going to be too high, it is going to damage the structure, right? That we don't want, and for that I will be having the thermal consideration, right? So for that we must provide some specific heat dissipation mechanism with the help of the given IC. The heat must not be trapped inside the IC. It is going to raise the temperature inside the packaging and then it is going to damage the IC that we don't want. And I hope you understand both of the design considerations, and I hope you all will be going through these books. These are really amazing books which you can refer for your further studies. And I hope you don't have any doubt now. If you have still any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment and I will be trying to resolve your doubt as soon as possible. I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also do share it with your friends. Thank you so much.